Now we look on to the arterial supply of the anal canal. So let us draw the anal canal. Okay, this is the anal canal. These were the anal columns. These were the anal valves forming the pectinate line. This was the white line of Wilton. This pectinate line is very important landmark, as it was dividing the anal canal into an upper part and the lower part, and each of these parts will have different blood supply, a different lymphatic drainage, and also different nerve supply. Therefore, this pectinate line is also known as watershed line. Okay, now the part of the anal canal above the pectinate line is supplied by the superior rectal artery. Superior rectal artery, which was the branch of the inferior mesenteric artery. And the inferior mesenteric artery was the branch from the abdominal aorta. Now the lower part, that is below the pectinate line, is supplied by the inferior rectal artery. Okay, which was the branch coming from the artery present in the pudendal canal, known as the internal pudendal artery, which was the branch of the internal iliac artery. Now the venous drainage. Now let us draw again a diagram of the anal canal. Okay, this was the pectinate line, anal columns. So the part above the pectinate line, this part, is drained by the radicles of the superior rectal vein with joints to form the superior rectal vein. Okay, this superior rectal vein then drains into the inferior mesenteric vein, which drains into the splenic vein, which finally drains into the portal vein. Okay, now the part below the pectinate line is drained by the inferior rectal vein, which drains into the internal pudendal vein. Which was present in the pudendal canal. This internal pudendal vein then drains into the internal iliac vein, which finally drains into the inferior vena cava or the caval system. So the part above the pectinate line is draining into the portal system, and the part below the pectinate line is draining into the caval system. Therefore, this area or side of the pectinate line is a site of portocaval anastomosis. Okay, now further details on this venous drainage. There are two venous plexuses associated with this anal canal, the internal venous plexus and the external venous plexus. The internal venous plexus is present in the submucosa, here a above the white line of the Hilton, which will be draining into the superior rectal vein, and also another vein here, which is the middle rectal vein. Okay, which will further drain into the internal iliac vein. The second venous plexus, that is known as the external venous plexus, is located around the lower part of the anal canal, just deep to the perianal skin, which will drain into this inferior rectal vein. So this was the internal venous plexus, and this one was the external venous plexus. Now the lymphatic drainage. So let us again draw a anal canal. This was the pectoral line, anal columns. Again, this pectoral line will act like a watershed line, and the lymphatics from the part above the pectoral line will drain into the internal iliac group of lymph nodes located along the internal iliac artery. Okay, and this internal iliac group of lymph nodes will further drain into the common iliac group of lymph nodes. So this was the internal iliac lymph nodes. Okay, and the part below the pectoral line drains into the medial group of the horizontal part of the superficial group of inguinal lymph nodes. So this was the medial group of horizontal part of superficial inguinal group of lymph nodes. So in these three conditions, we have seen that the pectoral line was acting like a watershed line. Now the nerve supply. Now again, the part above the pectoral line will be supplied by the autonomic nerves. That is, so the sympathetic fibers are coming from L1, L2 through the inferior hypogastric plexus, and the parasympathetic is coming from S2, S3, S4 through the pelvic splanchnic nerves. And the part below the pectoral line will be supplied by the somatic nerve, that is the inferior rectal nerve plus the perineal branch of fourth sacral nerve. Since these two nerves are somatic nerves, so this area is pain and temperature sensitive, and this area above the pectoral line, which was supplied by the autonomic nerves, is insensitive to pain and temperature but sensitive to stretch. Therefore, any lesion in this area is painless, and any lesion in this area would be painful. Also, the internal anal sphincter, which was located here, will be supplied by these autonomic nerves. Therefore, it is involuntary in nature, and the external anal sphincter would be supplied by these somatic nerves. Therefore, it is voluntary in nature. Also, developmentally, the part above the pectoral line develops from the endoderm and the part below the pectoral line develops from the ectoderm. So we can see how this pectoral line is a very important landmark in the anal canal. Now we will discuss about the clinical anatomy or the applied anatomy associated with the anal canal.